Alright guys, welcome back to the Mountain Man Initiative. Let's say you didn't watch my previous two videos on tools and things you'll need and how to tear this down and everything's a mess and everything's everywhere. You're screaming and crying in the fetal position. That's okay. I'm going to show you how to put all this back together again today in episode 3. Alright guys, one of the first things we want to do is before we put this thing together is identify two key things. Okay. As our locking bar in the proper position, which I showed you in last video. It's supposed to sit in this plastic piece here that's apart. If it's outside of it somewhere else, you're going to have a bad time. As our bright lever here in a bad position? Yes, that's going to need to get fixed and put into proper orientation. All right, which this is the problem, and this is going to get you. So what we're going to do is here, we're going to pull it all the way out, make sure it's all out and we got all the room. We're going to crawl underneath here through our sea of mess, and we're gonna look here at the dimmer switch. So what we're gonna do here is put this bar back in the dimmer switch. So we're gonna come in here and just drop it in like so, and then we're good to go. Now that part's fixed. Now we don't gotta worry about that. We're gonna make sure this here is up and good to go, and like it's not gonna fall back on us. All right guys, now you know your high and low bar is in position. It goes click. You know, for highs and lows, what you're going to do is you're going to take the stupid important piece here, which is your spacer for your lows and highs for your lights. So right here, how it curves down, that's how you're going to orientate it. You're going to have this indention here, and you're going to have this wonky teardrop looking shape going this way. That's how it's going to interface, like this. And then what you're going to do here is it's actually going to go in the bar like so. It actually sits like that. And then you got this channel here for this block here that sits in this piece like so. What you're going to do here is get it close, put it in that channel like so, and then you're going to drop it in like that, and you're going to hold it here. And keep it as straight and still as you can. It's going to want to do what it wants, but that's okay. Alright, once you get everything lined up and interfacing correctly, this is interfacing here, the shroud and the steering column and that, and your good old light spacer. The key here is this wire here. This wire is going to get you a lot. This one with the purple here, for me, you need to make sure that it's up and over the shroud like that, because that's what's going to bite you in the ass. So what you're going to do is make sure that's put up and into place. And then you're going to line it up with the locking pin first. And then from the locking pin first, you're going to line it up with the steering column. Or not the steering column, the light bright switch there. I like to use the picky tool for this. And move that into place because, like I said, it does what it wants. And everything should just drop into place like so. And you don't have to worry about those wires binding up. And then you'll just feel around and make sure all the seams are good to go and that there's nothing poking out of them. Once you do that, you could come here and grab these good old star bolts again and start putting them back, and we'll be good to go. All right, as you finish up tightening these, make sure you only do it like a quarter of a turn, or when they just kind of stop. It's going to be one of the two. You don't want them in there super tight. You just need them in there tight enough to hold it into place, and you'll be good to go. Alright guys, once you got this good old back and bolted together again, what you're going to do is you're going to take your key barrel, and if you got that bobby pin looking thing, like I said, that's the key buzzer, it actually fits in here and here at the same time. It's kind of goofy, but like I said, it just lets you know, hey moron, your keys are in here. But anyways, you just put it in like that, clicks in, no problem. Come over here, or wherever you decided to put your good old light buzzer switch, going, hey moron, you left on the lights. Go ahead and drop it in like so, and that sits just like that. So what you're going to do here is you're going to bolt this in first, and then from there you'll put your bar in here, your actuator bar, and then the good old hazard switch. So drop that in there, and then what you could do here is if you need to pull out the slack, you come back here and yank on that a little bit, not too ridiculous. Just enough to put it into place. Once you line it up, don't forget it's going to be these number size 2 or extra coarse threaded ones. These are the ones you want, and that's what you're going to drop back into there. You're going to use that number size 2 Phillips again. Alright, once you get those all in there, be careful that you don't strip anything. Like I said, those threads are pretty coarse. So what you're going to do is go ahead and flip this bad boy back to neutral, where it's not doing any blinking. And you're going to come back and grab your good old hazard screw. And you're going to kind of come in here, and it'll just drop into place. And this does cut new threads into new blinkers, FYI. So it's not a surprise there to y'all who are like finding it to be extra difficult. This is kind of keyed in a way, so it does key in there, so just note that. So what I do recommend is you get it started here, and then this is going to move around, and then when you get closer to tighten it down, then go ahead and match it where it keys up. Makes it a little bit easier. Might have to push all the way in on it. That's okay. As long as you get it in there. Alright. Once you're good there, and you're not going to strip it out, come back to that number 2 size Phillips. And we're going to drop this bar back in here and get it installed. So, got the little screw you had, and then this guy. Well, that's good, because you got this little channel in here. I don't know if y'all can see that. But you just plug it in there, and you'll be good to go. And once you do that, get that hole lined up, put that screw in there, and tighten her down. Again, be careful not to strip it out. So once we're here, make sure everything works. Hazards. Cool, that's all moving like it's supposed to. All right, now once you got your blinker switch installed and back to where it belongs, we're gonna go ahead and put all these guys back into place. Take your spring, drop that in there. Go ahead and take your horn, button, interface, doohickey, put that there. This cog is keyed, so you don't have to worry about misaligning this. And it's going to go ahead and drop in like so, just how you pulled it out. Alright, cool. Once you find where that key is, you'll just do that. Go ahead and take this ring. If it feel like it's not going to have enough tension, you can take some pliers and smash it down like so. Alright, now, once we got this all aligned and put back together like we just did, go ahead and grab your good old locking plate decompressor. And then go ahead and throw it on like you would. When you took it off, we'll be good to go. Then from here, go ahead and do the wing nut and bottom it out like before. Need all the room we could get. Alright, once that's all bottomed out, we're going to take this ring and we're just going to work it on there. Use your screwdriver again or the picky tool. I think the picky tool might be better. Once you get it over, it's pretty easy from here. You just push it on down. Probably better for the screwdriver here. And you're going to make sure it's seated. And once you know it's seated, you'll be good to go to release everything and undo it all. Good thing is here, that also locked our plate into place, so we know in advance it's working, which is good to go. So what we're going to do is grab our steering wheel, and we're going to go ahead and pull this metal monstrosity off that we had put on earlier. Alright, set that aside. And then this is where you want to grab your keys again and make sure your steering wheel is unlocked so we can get it lined up again. So that way it sits where it naturally wanted to again. And we're going to double check our marks and then we're going to line it up like so. So you got your marks here, line it up. We're going to push on as much as you can. Make sure that that play rests back on your notch. Go ahead and grab your nut and go ahead and hand tighten it down. You can also make sure you use your good old socket again and make sure it's hand tight. And that's the important part here. Now, if it locks again, it locks again. Don't worry about it. Probably better so you can get the torque you need on here, and then use the breaker bar and tighten her back down where she's tight. Alright, make sure it's good to go with that quarter of a turn. Alright, don't need to go past that, and we'll be good to go. Go ahead and grab your shroud here, and you're gonna put it back underneath like you did before. Or pull it out, I mean, and then that just plugs into there. And grab your good old panel. And then with your panel here, you got these two prongs, I guess, cylinders that hang off of it. and you're gonna drop it into here, into these wings or tabs that it's got. And then from there, you're gonna come up top and allow it to snap into place. Like so. And then we'll screw this back in and then install the horn. For this panel, just a recommendation, I'd probably line this top one up and that one or vice versa, and then put the rest in. It should make it a bit easier. All right, now since your panel's back into place, now we're good to go to put the horn in. Go ahead and take this wire that comes out of the hole and put it on the left tab here. And this one on the right, put it on here. And now drop that into place. Make sure your keys are in the opposition or out of there, because now we're gonna go put the battery back together and we'll be good to go. All right, since we're back at the battery, go ahead and get your socket good to go, or your wrench, whatever you're using. Go ahead and put that ground back together. I like to beat on it a little bit so it seats, and then hand tighten it down. And then ratchet it on there. All right, since our battery's connected, go ahead and start her. Make sure your blinkers are working. Obviously do go outside and go around and check. Obviously do your switches here for your brights to make sure you put it back together again. And, you know, move it around, go drive it, make sure she's aligned. If not, if she's not aligned for any reason, pop the hood back off, just rip off the steering wheel, and go as far left or as right that you need to do with the king, with the spline, and you'll be good to go. And that concludes episode 3 of tearing down your steering wheel, putting it back together again, guys. I appreciate it. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you guys think and want to see in the future. Have a good one. Bye-bye.